Hello everybody, what is going on? It's Jimmie here, back with another video. Today, my friends, I'd like to review the new game, Five Nights at Freddy's VR Help Wanted. This game is absolutely amazing. I don't really review a lot of games. I don't think I have any uploads right now that are reviews of games or anything. Most of those were done on the old channel back in 2016 that all got deleted for a copyright infringement, unfortunately. So most of the videos are gone permanently, but you're just gonna have to take my word for it. I used to do review stuff, but I don't really do it as much anymore, but I think I might start getting back into it because I do honestly enjoy reviewing things. But back to Five Nights at Freddy's VR Help Wanted, everyone. Five Nights at Freddy's VR Help Wanted is a virtual reality video game that puts you in the place of a worker at Five Nights at Freddy's. You can play the first three classic games, the vent repair. There's like all sorts of mini games, different modes you can play. My personal favorite ones to do was the vent repair. I just found them absolutely terrifying, really fun to do as well. Just not like just scary for being scary, like there was actually a point to them. And I really enjoyed that because things that are just scary for no reason are just like stupid. And I feel like that was a main problem with Five Nights at Freddy's 3, is that there was too many jump scares and it oversaturated the game. Nonetheless, Five Nights at Freddy's 3 remains as my least favorite out of the original trilogy. In this game, that is no exception. Five Nights at Freddy's 3 is a fun experience, but compared to the other two games, I would completely dismiss it. Five Nights at Freddy's 1 definitely runs the best, and when you make it to the nightmare mode, night 5 on Five Nights at Freddy's 1 is absolutely terrifying, putting you in a black and white scene, everybody, and it honestly really makes you feel like you're there, like you can interact with objects around you, you can really be there, and that is the thing I think that is just so good about this new installment in the series, everyone. It made you feel like you were there before, but just it never did a job like this. This game really makes you feel like you are the person there, and you also get some lore stories with the tapes and different things, this girl who tells you the parts of the story and different things. It's really cool. You guys gotta watch Game Theory. I'll leave him in the description. He goes over all that stuff. I'm not even gonna attempt to actually explain it because honestly, like, I don't know how to explain things very well. But yeah, there's like a whole story with stuff like that. But everyone, the thing that you gotta take away most from this game is that it will have you captivated for a long time. I have 29 hours into this game. That is definitely probably on the longer side out of any Five Nights at Freddy's. It's 54 hours on sister location. I don't really know how I racked up that much time. Most people do not have that much time in there, but that's beside the point. I think I will actually have more than that on this game because I'm trying to 100% the game, get every single tape, get every single coin, and right now I'm trying to 100% every single level. And then after that, I'm gonna go back and find all the tapes and coins and everything else, everyone. So I just really wanted to do this review to show you guys that I think you guys should all buy this game. We actually picked up an Oculus Rift just for this very game, everyone. Like, I'd never had experience with virtual reality. I've always wanted one since, like, the old channel. I don't know if you guys remember the podcast we used to do. One time we talked about virtual reality with one of our past members, everyone. But, I mean, it's honestly amazing. And this was my first experience with virtual reality, everyone. So I will put a little clip of my unboxing of virtual reality for the first time in this video at the end, probably. But everyone, you just gotta realize that this game is no joke. I mean, this game is genuinely terrifying, and if you're up for the challenge, I think you guys should all check it out. But I warn you guys that if you're not of the age to be able to play this, it probably should not be something you're playing because it will genuinely scare you. It really makes you feel like you're there, and if you're up for that challenge, then that's your choice. But I would just like to warn you before you get yourselves involved in something that you cannot take or that scares you too much, and then you're trying to request a refund from Steam and all that, which is pretty easy to do, but still, it's like you don't wanna have to go through all that, you know what I'm saying? Like, you just wanna be able to get a game, enjoy it, and everything else. If I was recommending a video game that was not Five Nights at Freddy's VR, if I was recommending a VR video game that was just fun on VR, I definitely recommend Super Hot VR because it is fun and it's not scary at all. I mean, it's not scary at all, but there's like things you can look down and make you feel like, wow, you're really there, but it's not scary. I feel like they've also expanded a lot on the story. The other games really had a little bit of story in them, and I feel like this game really shows the story a little more with the tapes because it's allowing you to learn about Jeremy and different things. Now, he eventually kind of commits suicide, I think is the point of that. I'm not really sure. We'd have to do more search into that, but I think that's what it's supposed to mean. This game is amazing. If I had to give it a review, I'd rate it a 9.5 out of 10 just because it is very glitchy sometimes, but I think they've pretty much patched all that up, so like if you guys are buying it within a month or two, by then stability updates and everything else will be put into place and everything should be fine by then.
That was my review of Five Nights at Freddy's VR Help Wanted. Final rating 9.5 out of 10. I've already went over why. We'll actually have a full review of the Oculus Rift S coming very soon, guys. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. Jimmie is out of here.